Hello everybody and welcome back to Farming Simulator 17 on Goldcrest Valley. Right, busy day today. What we need to do is we need to buy fur number 19, which is the fur we've been working on for the past day. Yeah, it doesn't sound very impressive that. But yeah, we do need to buy it. There is just, I think, one more job to do over there. And then we'll be able to purchase it. So yeah, I think it is fertilizing, if I remember correctly. So yeah. Head over here. Yeah, because we planted it. It is sugar beet. Some people didn't like that it was sugar beet because we don't have a sugar beet harvester. But it's okay because it'll be a while until it's ready anyway. At which point we should have either enough money to... Well, we do have enough money to rent a harvester, but it would be nice to buy one. Okay, so the fertilising is, well, slurry if we do it that way. Possibly it will change, let's just see. Oh no, it's sticking with the slurry theme there. Okay. Sorry, gonna make you feel sick in a second. I'm just trying to find a different tractor. Oh, let's just go with it. We'll go with this one. Okay, so today... Okay. That was easy. That was very, very easy. That was actually very weird. We just got given money for nothing. Okay, I'm guessing that is a glitch. Just turn this engine off. I was going to say, today, we're going to have another giveaway for Farming Simulator 17. I will just speed up time, and while we're waiting for the next mission to appear, I'll quickly explain what you need to do if you want to enter this giveaway for the PC version, it's a Steam version, of Farming Simulator 17. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to make sure you have your YouTube comments, or your YouTube messaging set up, so I can message you with the product key for Steam. And then you also need to make sure you're subscribed to this channel and you need to have rated this video. Doesn't matter if it's a like or dislike, hopefully it's going to be a like, but just as long as you rate the video, you will be eligible to be in the draw. You then have to comment on this video. That is the way I choose the winner. So make sure you've subscribed, make sure you've commented saying anything at all, doesn't matter. If you say anything, you'll be automatically entered, so don't comment if you don't want to win the thing, or if you do want to comment but don't want to win, just simply say, I don't know, something like, don't enter me into the giveaway. No missions yet. So yeah, hopefully that is everything. The terms and conditions are below, so if you want to read them in full detail, please do. In fact, I recommend that you do. But that is just the basic idea here. Just subscribe, comment, and rate, and you'll be entered into the draw. Any second now, there should be another mission. Please, come on. Come on. No missions yet. I suppose it needs to grow just a little bit before we can... Well, we've planted it, so... You know what? There probably isn't going to be another thing before harvesting. So we would be missing out if we buy it after harvesting. Let's just buy it. It is 41,342 euros. That is... Euros? Hang on, we were on pounds before. My Steam version has just updated. So I suppose it has... Yes, it has. It's reverted back. I'm guessing it's a patch. I've not looked into it yet. There we go. Okay, buy. We now own field number 19. Fantastic. So that was easier than expected. What we're going to do now is load up one trailer load of wood chips. I meant to do this yesterday but totally forgot. So one load in here. Now I did say yesterday that I wanted to get another trailer as well as this one. One person said to, yeah, they said to keep it. I've got the messages, I've got the comments here in front of me. So yeah, I agree. Let's keep it. I will read out some of the comments from yesterday's video in a minute or two, but I've only got one page, and this video was recorded just 3 hours after the release of yesterday's video, so obviously not all the comments are there yet. But yeah, just sort of skim reading here. It's very tempting reading them all. A lot of comments about the road rage, which was in yesterday's video. Yeah, they're quite positive comments actually, well handled and stuff. I like the way you keep it realistic with the road rage. Okay, what am I doing? Oh yeah, I I hate it when I do this. I sort of drift off and then forget what I'm going for. I'm going for the Manitou. So, we need to put the bucket on. And yeah, it's quite a high capacity bucket, so it won't take very long to fill this trailer. This trailer isn't very full anyway. It'd be nice to get some of the bits of wood chips which are on the outside of the shed here into the trailer first. So I'll try and scoop here. You know the pushing up levelers for the silage pits? I said in a multiplayer video, I think it was two episodes ago, that I couldn't use them, and everybody said, oh, you need to use the mouse and stuff. Well, it's very strange, my game is defaulted to not having an option for that, no control for it. So I'm going to have to set it in the options, which is very strange. On my laptop, I played the game, and it all worked fine. But for some reason, my PC, it never got a control for the levelers. Really weird. Yeah, I love this bucket. You get a lot in one go. It's almost, well, it's about 4,500. For some reason, it never fills 100%. Very weird. There we go. So, it didn't take it all, but it took a fair bit. We'll tip this back. I'm starting to get used to the controls now, because before I said that all the controls were opposite, but yeah, I'm getting used to it, it's good. Right, turn off there, that is all good. We need to go over to, I think, is it biomass? It must be biomass, this. So where is that on this map? Let's just have a look here. Biogas? okay. Let me just check. I would have thought it would have said biomass, but it doesn't seem to. It will sound here, so that is wood chips. Oh, the Stanton sawmill. Is that the only place you can take biomass to? Weird. So where is it? Oh yes, okay, so that's easy enough. We could cut across the bottom way, like I might do actually. But yeah, as you can probably see, the capacity of this trailer isn't very much, but I'm going to keep it for the smaller fields. That's where it would be very handy. And you can attach another one to it. So yeah, we might as well just keep it. I mean, we wouldn't be achieving much by selling it, because it won't be worth much. So yeah, we'll keep it in the farm's assets. Okay, right, so while we drive over to the Stanton sawmill, I will just have a quick skim read. Hang on, great demand at the Gomez Ridge Acres for soybeans, okay? We'll have a quick skim read through the comments from yesterday's video. So the first comment is written in gibberish. Okay, that's a strange comment. Okay, I won't read that out, that's kind of weird. I don't know what it says. It says, dagger, how get... how do you get the round bales wrapped? Oh, okay. I'm not used to that spelling. I'm sorry, I won't say your name just because it is pretty atrocious spelling. But yeah, how do you get them wrapped? Basically, you have to get the bale wrapper. It is an Ursus wrapper. I will show you here very, very quickly. This is turning into a tutorial video. You need to go into baling technology. You need to get this Ursus here, the Z586, and you'll be able to wrap your bales. Usually, it would be the grass bales or... Yeah, but the grass bales I'd have thought you'd go for. Yeah, sorry. I thought it was gibberish. Okay, next comment. Let's just quickly move on. Showing a video how to download mods. No, I could do, actually. You can actually download some of the mods from the main menu of the game itself. It says mods, you can go on there, and it'll bring up the mod hub. So if you want to go on there, you can do. What's the next one, then? The other pickup is bad. Oh, yeah, because I mentioned yesterday that we should probably buy the other pickup. Somebody obviously doesn't like it. Hey, that's Matthew! Is that the same Matthew as off the server? Spelt with no capital M. It could be. Where am I going? Where am I going? What am I doing? I would like to know. You don't tip them here, do you? No. Where am I going? That looks better. Put it over here. Selling point for wood chips. Here you may unload and sell your wood chips. And that is what we will do. We'll attempt to reverse in. I could have side tipped. But I like to practice. Because I hate it so much, I feel the need to practice. Then I might not hate it. That wasn't so bad. What is the tipping sign? Back. That is all good then. Off we go. Watch the money go up very, very slowly. They're just not worth anything, really. They're not the best. Someone called Official Diet says animals. They just say animals. That is the only thing. We are going to do animals today. We're going to buy some more sheep because I really want some more sheep. We got £1,973 for that. Yes, it was hardly worth it. But so well, doesn't matter. Oh, too busy looking at the comments. I'm not looking at the road. Ah, what's this one say? This one is about... Oh, it's about the road rage again. Justin says, impressive how you still kept it realistic when the AI pulled out in front of you. Because they did the same to me, and I had a bale spike on, and I just hit him with it. Okay. Yeah, I suppose it is an easy thing to do. I put the Manitou's bucket up the back of one of the cars yesterday. So which takes us back to the farm. We're very close now. Field 14 is just up here. Here we are, almost back. So this comment is going back to yesterday's video. Josh says, in America, we rarely use ploughs like that anymore. This is going back to the plough I used yesterday on the JCB. We just use chisel ploughs, or just use rippers and mulchers. Okay, that's quite interesting to hear. So maybe the ploughs aren't really the correct ones for the map. Put this back over here. Should be fine there. Turn it off. And what we could really do with is buying. Yes, we're going to buy something else. We need to buy the animal trailer because it is going to be used an awful lot. So it will be under animals, I believe. Where is animals? There it is. Oh, it's actually not too expensive. I thought it would be quite a bit more than that. So definitely worth it. Our money is going down. It's a sad sight, but we're doing okay still. One thing which I should probably point out here is that we do automatically have a loan. I didn't take it out myself, but when we started off the game, I think because we're playing on normal, we have a loan. So, yeah, that should probably be paid off because it does gain interest. Now I'm going to head up to the store. I'm going to pick up the new Joskin trailer, and we're going to then go down to Mary's farm where we can buy some sheep. I'm hoping to fill the trailer. They are quite expensive, but this is just a fantastic opportunity to have a good kickstart with the sheep. Well, we have two already, so it's not really a kickstart, but if we have nine more, that'd be good. The more we have, the more they reproduce, and obviously the more wool we have as well. The wool in Farming Simulator 17 is just worth an absolute fortune. Although the pallets fill up very slowly, especially compared to 15, it's still worth it because I think a pallet can be over £6,000, which is just incredible. So, yeah, it's going to be worth it. Let's go through Maplefield. I'm actually pleased that we've collected all the gold coins, not only for the money, but also because it has cleared the map up a bit. On the minimap before, we had all the different markers, and it was quite hard to see everything. So it's a good job I've collected them all. Oh, a lot of traffic. And we're actually going to need to be in that lane. So let's just pull across. I wonder if we'll have any road rage while leaving the store this time. We usually do. I don't think there's actually been a time when I've been down here without either being crashed into or crashing into someone else because of pulling out in front of me. So this will be interesting. This could be a first. It's nice to be able to afford stuff to buy though instead of having to lease. Leasing is, like I've said before, many times in fact, it is good short term, but long term it is terrible. They just don't look, do they? They just stroll out in front of you. If it's not the traffic, it's the pedestrians. Anyway, right. Mary's Farm is right at the bottom of this road. We'll branch off to the right at some point, and it will take us down to Mary's Farm. And at that point, we'll be able to buy... Here we go, look. Here we go. Can't believe it. We'll be able to buy 9 sheep. In fact, just looking at the comments once again from yesterday, somebody called Vash Dave says, "Dag, you should focus on the sheep so that they can now produce some more wool." That is exactly what we're going to do. Love the suggestion. Definitely a good thing to do. If you haven't entered the giveaway, please do. It's definitely, although there's only one copy of this, there's two before. Only one copy this time. It's still worth entering. Even if you've never won anything before in your life, there is still the chance of winning. Yeah, probably would have been easy to go over there, but sort of going the wrong way. I'll go off here. I would have thought that by now the sheep and the pigs probably need some more attention. You know how mucky they can be. The pigs especially, they sort of throw all of their corn out of their trough, and that is what you have to clean up. And it is a right mess when it's 100% dirty. I want to do some muck spreading because we haven't done any yet. It's something I really want to do. The pigs are producing it quite well, I think. The manure, it seems to be going up. Let's have a look on here. Where is it? There it is. Okay, someone is dirty. Oh no, they're not. That's the wool. Yes, they are. They're still dirty. Sheep are filthy. So we'll have to take the manatee over there. Yeah, these are going down, so they are going to need some work. But yeah, it's okay. Oh, actually, look at this. Cleanliness of the pigs. It's so dirty that it's zero. Fantastic. Yes, we're going to have to go over there with the manatee. We'll have a cleaning session. But first, we'll have a buying session. Sheep. £4,000 each. I think they were £300 on FS15. Oh, we can get 10 in. And this is going to cost us £40,000. Hopefully, this is the only lot we're going to have to buy because they should reproduce on their own. It's very good that they do reproduce because otherwise it would be a pretty tough deal. Keep this a fairly flat journey for them. We don't want to be bumping about too much. Although, with my driving, it's never too good. I don't think there is a follow me mod yet, is there? Has anyone seen anything? Because that mod was, in my opinion, probably one of the best in FS15. Follow me was just so useful. Like now, we could really do with having the Manitou following us from the farm to where the sheep are based, as we're going to need it. I'm sure it won't be too long, if there's going to be one, I don't know. It would be nice. This is our turning here. Yeah. Like I said before, we can't go too crazy with the money. However, we need to buy some more fields. Didn't I tell you before, £1 million wouldn't go very far. The economy in FS17 is quite... Well, it's very hard, actually. And to be honest, I think if I had known it was going to be quite as hard as this, I would have put the difficulty on easy. But the thing about doing that is a lot of people would say that I'm kind of, well, not cheating, but taking the easy option. Why have I gone up here? I have turned too early. Oh, look at this, tree down in the wind. Or is that the one I glitched? Not sure. They've been cut. Oh no, that's definitely a chainsaw. Must have been me, I suppose. Weird. Shame we can't just cut across there. Anyway, we'll turn left here, we'll go down to the farm, and that way we can cut across to field number 11, where we'll drop off the sheep. Then we'll get the money too, and tidy things up. So, that is where they are, just over there. This should be fairly painless, I'd hope. Case of just reversing up to the gate, unloading, and then we should have 12. 12 sheep roaming about. Not too sure how long it is until the next sheep is produced. I don't know how long it's going to be. Is that the gate there? I think it is. So we need to unload all 10, confirm, and yep, there they all are. It's looking a lot better now, rather than just two sheep stood in a piece of grassland. The only thing is they're going to need quite a bit more grass eventually, as they're going to eat more, and well, it's more of them to eat, to feed, and more water as well. But that should all be fine. So how mucky are you? Yeah, you've spilt a bit of grass here and there. I don't think they're terribly dirty, but I'm dreading seeing the pigs because they don't have any cleanliness at all. We'll see you in a second. Off to go and get the mighty. Now, best place for this trailer, I would have thought, is just up against this storage shed here. I'll probably create a new area. I do want more storage, but we do have to prioritise the animals first of all. There we go. Yeah, this trailer is still parked here. I think we'll just attach to it, ready for another episode. And then we need to just jump into the money too. And leave the vent here for today. We've already put half an hour on this tractor. Put it back over here. There we go. It's a bit neater. Brilliant. Okay. Where did I put the money to? Oh yeah, it's up here. Oh dear, short term memory today. Don't know why. But yeah, I think really the farm is progressing as I would have hoped. The money was just so helpful. Without it, I think we'd be struggling. But it is actually the first time I have collected every single collectible in a farming simulator game. I did do very well in Farming Simulator 08 with the glass bottles. We had to recycle them. Obviously, there were no Let's Plays of that by me. I never started to Let's Play until... I didn't start Let's Play until FS15, actually. Amazingly. But I've been playing Farming Simulator from the beginning. First time I played Farming Simulator was in January, beginning of January, 2009. When it was just before the release of FS09, but it was still 08. Was the current game. Right, what am I doing? Yes, go over here. There I go again. So yeah, been with Farming Simulator for the entire time it's been out. The first time I ever played it, it was about 1 in the morning. Don't ask me why I was playing Farming Simulator at 1 in the morning. I suppose it's something a lot of people do these days. But yeah, I used to go to bed very late, not anymore. I've got too much to do during the day now. Let's do other stuff, and then of course record a video every day as well, which I absolutely love. Something I look forward to every day is to come back, record a video. The only time I hate it is when something either messes up with the rendering, or I don't know, maybe a corrupt file or something which messes things up. That is when I hate doing this, but that is the only time. Love recording, that's the best bit. Editing, not as good. But yeah, as I was saying, 1 o'clock in the morning I was playing FPS 08, and the first mission, well, it was a trial mode actually, I didn't buy the game straight away. I was playing the demo. It was in the days when there was a demo for this game. And you could harvest one small wheat field. Wheat was the only crop in FS 08, nothing else. And I just kept harvesting the same field over and over again because I thought, this game is amazing. And then, oh wow, if you look back at it now, it's nothing. But it is the starting point, and every game has to start somewhere. So this shouldn't be too hard, we should just have to scoop up. Oh yeah, the other mission for FS 08 was the... You had to use the snowplow and the dozer blade to move the logs out of the road, which I remember very clearly. To be honest, I wish I had started to Let's Play a bit earlier than I did do, but yeah, I just never really thought of doing it. I mean, even when I did start, I didn't think it would be anything too serious. I thought I'd just put a video on, and that'd be it. But it's sort of, you know, evolved into this, and it's amazing. So good. Right, next place to go to is the pig farm. This could be quite a bit dirtier. And I have just very quickly looked at the statistics again, and it says that the corn is now amber, orange now. So can we put some in the bucket and take it over there? I can't really see why not. That would be quite a good idea. And then choose tip anywhere to put it in a pile in the shed. I'll try it. If it doesn't work, fair enough. But it should do. Oh, it always stops me. Great demand at Goldcrest, Pacific grain for soybeans. More soybeans. Now is the time to sell soybeans. How much do we have? Soybeans, here we go. Just there. We have none. But the price is really good. So it just shows you that holding on to the crops, if you can do, until a great demand comes in, is definitely worth it. It's just being able to afford to hold onto the crops. Sometimes you have to sell them straight off if your financial issues are anything like what mine used to be. So my plan is just to boom this up into the auger, or whatever it is, the pipe for the silo, and we should be able to collect some corn in the bucket. I know they don't take much, so if I can sort of judge how much they're going to take, that would be better, but it's going to be very hard to judge. Is it even going to work? I thought it would do, but... Doesn't seem to work. That's annoying. I really would have thought it would have worked. So you have to use a trailer. Okay. Fair enough. It is just starting to go a bit dark as well. Yeah, I've just seen another comment. This is from Captain Tacticus. This is on yesterday's video. Now they say, if you're going to replace one of the case tractors, this is what I said, you should really get the Massey Ferguson 7700. It is better than the JCB Fast Track, as it has more power lower maintenance costs, and it also supports a front loader attachment. Unlike the JCB, it is an ideal upgrade as it has the power to use much better equipment, and plus it's a Massey Ferguson, so why wouldn't you buy it? Well, I like the point you've put across there. Very tempting. Is a Massey Ferguson 7700 going to be our next tractor? Well, highly likely, as we've already got a Fendt. So thank you very much, Captain Tacticus. I appreciate it, and you have put an idea into my mind. I have done this before where I've read out comments in the video. Do you like it when I do this, or is it just a bit annoying? I'd love to know some feedback. This wasn't as bad as I was expecting, really. I thought it'd be worse. That should clean them up. And here's some corn for you. Just what you've always wanted. Oh, they've just spilled some more. Dirty things. But quite a bit as well. Have it back. There. Right, I'm just gonna increase time. Just very quickly. It should do, and it should have updated. Yes, cleanliness of both is 100%. Always looks good. We now have 13 pigs. And there's another one coming in 2 hours and 22 minutes. They should technically be piglets, but they're not. They're just instantly fully grown pigs, unless they fly in from another planet. Who knows? How much manure do we have then? Anything decent? It's okay, I suppose. It's a bit of a splat on the floor, but I suppose it would be one bucket load. Is it one bucket load? Seems a shame to get such a nice clean bucket dirty. Okay, it's 34% of a bucket. Probably the only occasion when I want them to poo more, so it'll benefit us, and yeah, I get to do a bit of muck spreading, which I really want to do. Now, I'm going to put this... Actually, do they need water? Water? Yeah, they could do it a bit. If there's anything in here and we can attach to it, I'll give them some. But it might be the wrong hitch. Oh, wow. That's the first time I've noticed that mirror. And it's actually aligned with the hitch. Can I do it then? Can I align with the tanker? Is it about there? Where is it? I've crashed into it. I've crashed into the tanker. Obviously, it's a bit further over. There it is. I just saw it come into view. Yeah, somewhere here. There we go. Perfect hitching. Love that. Should always have that aligned. And yes, there is some water in here. It's 87% full. So we'll give them some. They don't need an awful lot, but it's just a bit of a top up. Look how flat that tyre is. No, wrong one. Okay, yeah. Really not too much at all there. I think that is going to bring our video to the close. That is today's episode. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. We'll be returning very soon with the next episode. Most likely tomorrow, unless I'm going to be doing another multiplayer one. But it's usually just one multiplayer a week. It kind of depends what mood I'm in. Also, if I want to do some multiplayer, I will do. But yeah, usually, well, at the moment, the server is a bit of a nightmare, crashing every half an hour or so. So maybe if this was a patch before I played on here, then they might have fixed it. But who knows? We'll have to find out later. But that is it. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. And I hope to see you again in the next video. See you again soon. Bye for now.